Welcome back. A Valley man says technology is helping him manage diabetes. He started off disinfecting needles by boiling them in water. Now he uses his smartphone. Channel 5's Christian Colon reports.
At 13, Mark Dennis Bush encountered a disease he thought was temporary.
At first, I was concerned because I knew it was going to be, I didn't realize that it'd be a lifelong problem, I don't think. At least that impression didn't hit me at that point. But I think as time went along, I understood this was forever.
For 59 years, Bush has lived with diabetes. He says he learned to do all the home treatments by himself. He would test his sugar levels by inserting a device into his urine. He would also inject himself with insulin using giant needles. That all changed.
When I first got diabetes, my mother boiled the syringe every morning with a needle in the pan. So we had to deal with it that way. That's how I took a shot in the mornings every day when I got up.
And now?
I carried my vials, and now I have an insulin pump. So it's changed a lot.
In his 30s, he got his first glucometer. Now his insulin pump is connected to his iPhone. That gives him minute-to-minute updates on sugar levels. He says technology made his life much easier. We spoke to Pamela Lopez, a nurse practitioner in McAllen, and she says new gadgets have made it more painless. They can avoid their fingers being pricked in order to see your sugar levels. Lopez says there is another device that checks your levels by just a quick scan.
Actually, just kind of press it on and it sticks on, and then you remove it and the sensor is left in place, almost like a Band-Aid is left in place. So once it's on, it takes about an hour for it to start reading. And once you have it in place and you want to check your sugar, all you would do is turn on your device, press read, and then you would just scan it and you get an instantaneous number right away.
Lopez says this is making patients have more self-care. They see the data for themselves. If something seems off, patients can easily report it to their doctor. The patient and doctor relationship is key. Another program serving diabetic patients is this machine. It analyzes the patient's body to prevent or follow up on complications in the nervous system and vascular system. Diabetic patients might begin to feel weakness, numbness, and pain from nerve damage in the hands and feet. This machine tells the doctor the area in need of further testing. Bush advises diabetic patients to build a relationship with technology. It has served him well.
I still have my legs, I still have my feet, and a lot of diabetics after this many years don't have that.
If you would like to learn about these new gadgets, visit our website at krgv.com. Christian Colon, Channel 5 News.